Hello dear students, very good morning to you all. In today's class I teach you the next conditional statement available in C language, that is the fourth one, else if ladder. Till today we studied about the simple if, as well as afterwards I taught you the if else. Afterwards we studied the nested if. As we know all, simple if was one way decision making statement. No choice for computer system. But if else was two way, machine was having two choices, machine was executing one of the two. Okay, that's why we called that if else as two way. In the last class I taught you the nested if. In if only, if you make the use of if, that is called as nested if. Nested if was multi way decision making statement available in C language. Similarly, else if ladder is also one of the multi-way decision making statement available in C. But before discussing about the else if ladder in detail, else if ladder is also called as cascaded if. Fine. Why it is called as else if ladder? Look at this flow chart. You can see the structure of ladder here. Step number 1, step number 2, step number 3, step number 4. Here we are getting the pattern of a ladder. Why we are getting this pattern, we'll come to know shortly. No need to worry. That's why it is called as else if ladder. And it is also called as cascaded if. Don't get confused in examination. If there is a question on cascaded if, you need to explain the else if ladder only, because else if ladder is also called as cascaded if. I hope you know what is the meaning of the word cascade. Cascade means fall on one another. Waterfall or whatever that might be. This type of pattern is also called as cascading. So it is called as cascaded if. Why it is called as else if ladder? Shortly we'll come to know. In today's class we discuss the explanation for else if ladder. Then I explain you the syntax. Then I explain you the flowchart. Then we discuss about the working of else if ladder. Then I explain you two programs. One is to find largest of three numbers by using else if ladder. And one more is to display the grades like distinction, first class, second class, pass or fail. We solve this problem also by using else if ladder, and we solve this problem also by using else if ladder. At the end I give the demo by using Turbo C++ editor. That is what we discuss in this lecture video. Let us start with the explanation for the else if ladder. Why else if ladder is called multi-way? Same answer is there. What is that? Machine executes one of the multiple choices. For computer system, multiple ways will be there, but the machine follows one of the way, so it is called as multi-way. But the problems whichever we can solve by using nested if are different. The problems whichever we can solve by using else if ladder are different. But practice will come to know. We need to solve this problem by using else if ladder only. To solve that problem, nested if is only suitable. But practice you come to know, no need to worry. Okay, whenever I give the example, you'll come to know. Let us start. And just only we learned that this is also called as multi-way decision making statement, or branching, or conditional, or selection statement available in C language, because it executes one of the multiple blocks based on what? Given condition. So it is called as multi-way decision making statement or conditional statement available in C language. And why it is called as else if ladder? Answer is here. You can see here, this is the if else. Okay, if else. Okay, if this condition is true, this works, otherwise this works. But interesting thing here is that where this if else is used. If else is used only in the else part of the previous if else. You can see here, one more if else is there. Okay, this is also if else, but next if else is used in the previous else part of the if else only. You can see one more interesting thing here. Second if else is used here, the sky blue colored one. Second if else is used where? It is used in the else part of the previous if else. It is also one type of nesting, but nesting we are doing in systematic manner. We use if else only in the else part of the previous if else. If else is used only in the else part of the previous if else. Because of this reason only we are getting this pattern. See here, this is if else, no? If the condition is true, this works. If it is false, one more if else is used. If it is false, one more if else is used. If it is false, one more if else you can use. That means this is if else where it is used in the false part of the previous if else. This is if else where it is used in the false part of the previous if else. That's why we are getting this ladder pattern here. So it is called as else if ladder or cascaded if. I hope you understood. Now for computer system, how many choices are there? First choice, second choice, third choice, and the fourth choice. Whether the machine follows all the four? No. Machine follows one of the block, not all the blocks. Now at what time the statement 1 works? Okay, at what time the statement 1 works? If the first condition is true, then statement 1 works followed by statement X. Assume that the first one is true, then the statement 1 works. Okay, if first is true, statement 1 works, then the statement X works. Assume that first one is false, then machine will not run the statement 1. Then machine will check the expression 2. At what time the second will be checked? If the first is false. If the first is false, statement 1 works, then remaining statements. First is true, first one works, over. First is not true, then second will be checked. Second is true, second works, followed by remaining. Assume that first is also false, second is also false, third is true. Third is true means third one works, followed by statement X. Assume that first is also false, second is also false, third is also false. Then the default statement works, followed by statement X. Oh, interesting. See here, same explanation is here. If the condition 1 is true, statement 1 works, statement X. At what time statement 2 works, can you tell me? First one is false, second is true, then the second works, followed by statement X. At what time the third works, can you tell me? First is also false, second is also false, third is checked by machine, third is true, then machine executes this block. This block may have multiple instructions, then it executes statement X. Let us assume first is also false, second is also false, third is also false. Then the default block works. Means default block works at what time? If all the conditions are false. To explain you, I have taken only 3 conditions here. It is not compulsory that you need to take only 3. You can take more than 3 also. Expression 4, 5, 6, n number of expressions you can check depending on the software whichever you are developing, or the problem whichever you want to solve by using the else if ladder. I think you understood. And don't give the semicolon for the condition here, as you know already. Okay, don't give the semicolon here. It is most important. And one more important is that else and if space must be there. Else and if space must be there. Don't write like this. You get syntax errors. Okay, I hope you understood. In exam, if you explain like this, find 5 marks. If you explain the syntax like this, 1 marks. If you draw the flowchart neatly, don't use scales and everything. Freehand sketch neatly. Labeling must be correct, true or false, arrowhead, everything must be neat. If you do so, no, you get very good marks. And if you have time, you can explain it. If the given expression 1 is true, statement 1 works, followed by statement X. First one is false, second will be checked for true or false. If second is true, then the statement 2 works. No, then the expression 3 will be checked. If it is true, then like that, that works, and so on. If all the expressions are false, then the default statements are executed by a computer system followed by statement X. And compulsory, you need to write syntax and draw the flowchart. And if you have time, you can explain. And don't forget to write minimum 1 program as example. Okay. First, I teach you interesting example. This example, you can see the table here. It is having percentage of marks. If your percentage of marks is in between 70 and 100, distinction, first class with distinction, congratulations. If your percentage of marks is in between 60 and 70, first class, 50 and 60, second class, 35 to 50, pass, lesser than 35, fail. Okay, now we are developing on software. Enter your average marks. I entered 77. My average marks is more than 70, no? My average marks is more than 70 means we get the result like first class with distinction. okay, because 77 comes in between 70 and 100. Sorry. Sorry. Okay, if percentage of marks is in between 70 and 100, distinction. Okay, so percentage of marks is 77. I am getting first class distinction. If I enter 65 first class, 55 second class, 35 pass, 25 fail, I get accordingly. How to write the program? It is so easy. Just I take one variable as average of the type float, then I clear the screen, enter reverse average marks. Whatever you enter, that will be stored in average variable. If that variable is having the value more than or equals to 70, then only this works. Assume that you entered 77. 77 is more than 70? Yeah. Then it displays first class with distinction. Then statement X gets each program is over. Assume that you entered 65. 65 is more than 70? No. No means it will check. More than average marks is more than equals to 60? Yes, definitely. 65. Then we get first class. Assume that you entered 55. 55 is more than 70? No. 55 is more than 60? No. 55 is more than 50? Yeah. We get the message second class. Then the getCH works. Okay. If you enter 40, 40 is more than 70? No. More than 60? No. More than 50? No. More than or equals to 35? No. We get pass. Then getCH. If you enter 25, false, 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 then fail, get CH. I hope you have understood this program. If you write this program, evaluator will be happier and evaluator gives you marks. Important thing is that don't give semicolon for the if condition and maintain space between else and if. And blue colored one works every time. Red colored one is the cascaded if or else if ladder. Okay, thank you. One more program, same problem. Largest of three numbers, int a, b, c, and we are reading three numbers, and else if ladder we are using here. See here, if else is used, where it is used, in the else part of the previous if else, a must be greater than b, logical and, this is called as logical and, truth table of logical and you might be knowing, if both are true, then only true, a must be greater than b, a must be greater than c, then only a is greater. No, if any one of them false or both false, then else if works. If B is greater than A and B is greater than C, then B works. If any one of them is false or both are false, it will not work. This is also false, this is also false, then definitely C will be the largest. Okay, then the end works every time. And if you enter 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 3 is greater than 1, 2, yeah, 3 is greater than 1, yeah. Then 3. The end. As per this input, this block works. One of the three works, not all the three. Multiway. I hope you have understood. Let us I run the program and I will show you practically. I run the Turbo C++. Double click on that. Then what we do? We know it. How to write the program. First, which one shall I explain? Displaying grades, okay. Hash include stdio.h. Then we go for the main function. Then we take here my program is started, here my program is over. I go for one variable, that is average variable. Then I clear the screen. Machine clears the screen. Then it prints the message, enter reverse average marks. Enter reverse average marks. Okay, nice. How to read the marks? We go for the scanf, then percentage f, then ampersand avg. Okay, okay, then wait. Okay, just it reads and it waits. File and save, and I give the file name as aa1 compulsory.c. Now run the program. AVG is allocated, enter your average marks 67, get CH is working. Okay, but problem is not solved fully. I correct the spell mistake. Then tab if tab is not compulsory, but better you have to use it. If average marks is more than or equals to 70, don't use semicolon, tab. If it is true, then printf, then slash n, first class with distinction. First class with distinction. Okay. At what time the machine displays this? If the first condition is true, assume that is false, then it goes for the next one. That is, if average is more than equals to 60. If it is so and so, I go for the printf. Then slash n means cursor comes down. First class. Your result is first class. You can type any appropriate message, not only this. What I do? I go for copy paste. Shift and down arrow. Edit menu. Copy, control insert. Then edit menu, paste, shift insert. Okay, this is for second class. This is for pass. This is for fail. Okay. Copy paste. You can complete the program like this early. That's why become perfect with the shortcut keys. If it is more than 35, otherwise that will be fail. Okay. More than equals to 60 means that is first class. If it is not more than 60, it will check for more than equals to 50. That is in between 50 and 60. Then here I type second class. Sorry. Not more than equals to 35, then definitely that will be fail. First attempt in learning, F-A-I-L. Okay. Whenever you fail in subjects, don't get upset. That is the first attempt made by you, and you have to improve a lot. Okay. Now I hope you understood. Run the program. I enter 77, first class with distinction. Run 66, first class. I enter 55, second class. I enter 35. Oh, I have not changed the message here. 35, which message must be there here? Can you tell me? Pass. Sorry. Okay. Now run it. I go for 40. Pass. Okay. Then I enter 24. First attempt in learning. I hope you understood. Very good. I run one more program. That is the largest of three numbers. Control Y, deleting a line. Control Y if you press deletes line. I go for three variables, A comma B comma C. Then I clear the screen. Screen is going to clear. If you are working with Turbo C++, then only you have to use it. Otherwise, no need to use. Printf. Enter any three numbers. Enter any three numbers. Okay. How to read the numbers? You know it already. Very good. Scanf, scan formatted data, %d, 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 then address of which variable? A, address of B, then address of C variable. Afterwards, what we do, we go for tab. If suppose A is greater than B, logic aligned, twice, A must be greater than C, then which one is greater? Printf, slash n, %d, then A. Okay, you can display appropriate message also. Go for else and if. If B is greater than A and B is greater than C, then we go for the printf, then slash n, %d, then the B. Okay, if this condition is also false, we go for the printf, then slash n, %d, then the C. Okay. Now I go for getch, then code is over, save it. Okay, I hope you understood. If A is greater than B, A is greater than C, print A. You can give tab gap, not compulsory. If you give the tab gap, the logic will be clear. If this condition is true, this works. If this condition is true, this works. Okay, if it is true, if it, both are false, this works. Now run it. One error, missing semicolon. Oh nice, here missing semicolon. Save it and run. 1, 2, 3. Oh wrong. Where is the mistake? Can you tell me where is the mistake? %d is missing in scanf. %d, yes. Okay, thank you. Run. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I hope understood. You can trace by pressing F7 also, function F7, line by line you can check. I enter 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1. Okay, 3 is greater than 2, yes, 3 is greater than 1, yes. See here, F7, which part works? Yeah, it is true. Get CH, program is over. Okay, now again, once again, trace it, F7. I enter which values? Okay, instead of 3, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3. Okay, 1 is greater than 2, false. 1 is greater than 3, false. If first one false, false only. F7. It will check the next condition. Oh, B, 2 is greater than 1? Yeah, okay. 2 is greater than 3? False. It will not work. Then go for which one? F7. Okay, last one, C prints. Like this, you can trace line by line by pressing F7. I hope you understood today's program and the cascade if. It is so easy. If you have any doubts, please ask, write in comments. Share this lecture video among your other friends also. Thank you. Have a nice day. Take care.